March 2006. The single largest wildfire disaster in state history scorches the plains of the Texas Panhandle. The losses mount quickly from the East Panhandle Complex wildfire. Two major fires burn more than 800,000 acres in just a 48-hour period. Both fires exceed the Big Country Fire near Abilene, which burned 366,000 acres from March 10th to the 15th, 1998. Reports of 75-mile-per-hour winds and extremely dry conditions help fuel the blazes. The Borger Fire burns an area 72 miles long and 20 miles wide. 450,000 acres are lost, along with 8 homes. The Borger Fire becomes the largest fire in Texas history. The I-40 fire begins in southwestern Gray County. It becomes the second largest wildfire on record in Texas as 390,000 acres burn. Nearby Interstate 40 is shut down and 8 towns are evacuated. The blaze stretches 55 miles long and 20 miles wide. 12 people lose their lives, including one firefighter. The losses continue to increase. 10 homes are destroyed, along with an undetermined number of outbuildings and 80 vehicles. The Borger and I-40 fires burned for 6 days. She ran calling wildfire. She ran calling wildfire. She ran calling wildfire.
At times, different people were clocking the speeds of the fire. It was covering a mile every 2 minutes. We were burning a section of grass every 2 minutes.
The Texas Animal Health Commission records 4,500 livestock deaths attributed to the fires. Over 5,000 miles of fence is destroyed. The Texas Forest Service says the combined efforts of hundreds of volunteer and full-time firefighters from across the Panhandle, Texas, and many neighboring and distant states becomes the largest firefighting mobilization ever in the state of Texas.
People are really taking a hard hit by this thing with their farmers and ranches, etc., and so forth. And in all that time, in those first few days, when nobody knew really what they had left of ranches and farms that had taken years to put together, I never heard one people say, well, where's the government and what they're going to do for me? The only question I heard that was raised was, what can I do to help? And that came from even those that took a pretty good hit from the fire.
Help arrives in a big way. The Gray Roberts County Farm Bureau in Pampa and the Texas Farm Bureau in Waco organize and oversee an overwhelmingly successful fire assistance program. A collection site is set up in Pampa for farmers and ranchers in need. Donations come in from throughout Texas and from across the nation. In the end, the totals are quite impressive. 1,500 large round bales of hay, 450 tons of range cubes, 33 miles of fencing materials, including posts and barbed wire, and more than $149,000 in cash. Transportation and labor are provided by people from everywhere. Students from Texas A&M University donate their time and efforts for 2 weeks in May to help tear down fences and clear debris destroyed by the fires in several Panhandle counties. The work the students donate, when compared to commercial costs for the same operation, is worth in excess of $50,000 to the ranchers.
They've got goals set. They wanted to get 50 miles worth of fencing cleaned up. If they do a mile, it's $1,000 worth of labor that these farmers and ranchers are saving. So, you know, they kind of had a goal to save, you know, the neighborhood of $50,000, and I think they're going to pass that.
I mean, unfortunate things happen, but the only thing that makes it where you can get through this and make it easier is all the wonderful people that have donated their time, money, like this hay. That's what makes it where you can, you know, lift your head up and get through each day. Without any help, this would be unbearable.
Help has literally come from coast to coast and border to border. We've had people donate hay, people who donate cubes from various states around here. We've had numerous people offer to donate time, such as the students from A&M. We've had cowboys offer to bring down horses from Colorado to help round up cattle. and then people have opened up their pocketbooks and have donated hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Also part of the relief effort are two benefit concerts featuring cowboy singing artist Michael Martin Murphy and other entertainers. A Pampa concert raises money for local volunteer fire departments, while an Amarillo concert raises more than $60,000 for the affected farmers and ranchers, elevating the total amount of cash donations to more than $210,000 for the Texas Panhandle Wildfire Relief Effort.